Okay, so you mentioned that there were, that you're gonna have greenhouses, so.
Yes.
This is a farm that's gonna be running year-round and producing crops that aren't necessarily in season?
Yes, very good question. We are going to have approximately 6 greenhouses, and each one of them will be its own ecosystem. We'll have even a banana and coffee one, we're gonna do a tropical greenhouse, we're going to do a desert greenhouse, we're going to do a high desert deep greenhouse, and what have you. So we'll have, each one of them have their own climate control and ecosystem in each one. So we'll be able to grow all different kinds of varieties. Great question. Any more?
Yeah, what are you planning on doing for distribution? So where you have your own car that you'll be taking into the markets?
Well, like I said, we're gonna be as local as we possibly can. So it'll probably just be a nice little refrigerated van. John and I'll just give it to the restaurants. That's my main focus. Remember I said restaurants. Because I only have 5 acres up there. Now I can grow a lot of food on 5 acres, but I want to grow it just for Flagstaff and Sedona. You see, so I don't want to, I'm not big enough to have this huge, that's why I was saying the supermarkets would be great, but I don't know if I have a farm big enough to really handle more supermarkets than maybe the one here in Flagstaff. Not, you know, all of it. So if we were going to focus on any supermarkets, one of the teams is going to do that. Just do the ones here and the ones, because that would be all the ways. Because then I'm professing my own sustainability. If I'm shipping it somewhere far, I mean, it doesn't make sense. I'm contradicting what I'm trying to do here. Question? Any more? Really? So nobody's, yeah, go ahead. You can ask all you want. The only dumb question is the one you don't ask.
So. What does it look like? For, how many employees do you have?
Right now I have 2 employees. They're sitting right back. Well, 3. Okay. My wife, my son, and my daughter.
Okay.
That's what we have right now. And we'll probably end up getting interns, you know, from the botany classes and things like that. It doesn't really take a lot. It doesn't really take a lot of what we're doing here.
What are you using when you pick the produce to, what kind of containers are you using when you ship it to such stuff?
Well, we, like I said, we don't have anything in the grain. We're just,
okay.
This is just the emphasis. But we'll use wooden crates.
Okay.
Yeah, and maybe Navajo baskets, things like that. Everything that we're trying to do is, somebody made it around here. The crate, from the building materials that we're using, we're gonna actually build the homestead on the sustainable county sustainability program. We're gonna be a certified sustainable homestead. So everything is going to be the proper materials and, you know, low chemicals involved and things like that. So I'm curious, why did you ask that question? That's interesting.
I was just curious, as a sustainable
yes.
farm, how much...
How are we going to get and reuse everything, yeah.
Yeah.
Right, that's a very good question. Yes?
I know you said there wasn't another company like this, so but who would be your sort of main competitors?
I'm sorry, sir. I can't hear out one ear about this from the other.
So I know you said there wasn't anybody like yourselves.
Uh-huh.
Who would sort of be your main competitors?
Competitors? That's a very good question. I have 0 competitors. I'm an ex-Marine, ex-boxer, ex-this, ex-that. I had competition all my life. Now there will be no competition in this. I do not want competition. Us farmers that are doing what we are going to do should not be in competition because there's so much demand for this. Seriously, you guys, the restaurants, you'll find this out when you ask them. They need more farms, so there's no competition. And if there is, let the other guy try to compete with me. I don't want to compete. I'm going to grow this many vegetables, and however many people want them can have them. No competition. I'm off the grid. I'm out of the corporate world. And I don't want any competition. Does that make sense?
You said you're completely rain reliant, right?
Yes.
So what are the problems that could possibly you face, and how do you combat that?
I can't combat it unless I can be God.
Do you
the
collect
problem that I might face is no rain. Gee, we're in Arizona, that could happen.
Do you collect rainwater?
Yes. It's called a water catchment system. The water catchment system will be off the roof of the barn and the roof of the house. So we have a house here. Can I ride on this?
Yeah, absolutely.
House here like this, big barn with big roof. For every 1,000 square feet of roof, when it rains 1 inch, I'll get 600 gallons of water. And we're going to have 5,000 square feet, roof between the barn and the house. So somebody tell me 5,000 square feet of roof, every time it rains an inch, how many gallons of water will I have? Very good, very good. So yeah, it needs to rain. It needs to rain, but up there it gets about an average of 23 inches a year. So we should be able to collect about 50,000 gallons a year. We'll have 20,000 gallons worth of tanks. Yes?
Is there another question?
Yeah.
Would you consider snow to be an alternative since it does snow here?
Snow, we will have the snow and the snow catchment also. What we do there is we put peat strips on the roof towards the gutters right here. Well, this is an interesting class. They're asking all these technical questions. And the heat strips will slowly melt the snow. Doesn't allow it to shut, you know, they have little catchment areas, so the snow slowly melts instead of just falling off, and it goes down into your catchment and underground. Very good question. So if anybody does find somebody, go ahead.
I think, what's your goal of getting all this up and running?
My goal is we will be breaking ground in approximately 60 days, and John and I plan out to be completely built out within 5 years. In other words, first greenhouse, 6-7 months later, next greenhouse. We really want to know each system before we go to the next one. That's a great question. 1 to 5 years.
Thank you.
Anybody else? Yes.
I don't know how far your 5 acres is from the snow bowl, but the snow bowl uses reclaimed water to make snow. How could you prevent the runoff from contaminating your crop?
Very good question. When it runs off into these gutters, now this side of the barn will go into our house. And my house, has anybody ever heard of earthships? House and earthship? You guys are all business majors, aren't you? I'm used to going talking to my sons and friends, and they're all sustainability, right? So, anyway, where was I on that? When it's like the city has their own water treatment plant, we will have a water treatment plant in our home, obviously small scale, and that'll be how we do that. Over here, when it runs down off this side of the barn and going into these tanks to handle all of the greenhouses, we will have, and we don't have to have, by the way, we will have, because we want to have it, and our standards are higher than the government's, we will have charcoal filters going down in through the gutters, and the water will enter a filtration system before it goes into the tank, and then after it comes out of the tank, before it goes on, it'll have another filtration system. You see what I'm saying? And we don't really need that water catchment for the, because I was concerned about that. I was concerned about, you know, bird poop on the roof or whatever is going down. But it rains, when it rains outside on an outdoor crop, there's nothing filtering it. It just rains on your crop, right? But when it hits your roof, there could be some contaminants. So that's why we decided to go ahead and filter it in two different spots. We don't need a water treatment plant, because we're not drinking. But we still want to filter out any pathogens that could be. Somebody had a question over here. Over here?
Just what varieties of produce do you plan on growing and which ones to
grow? Great question. And that's the one that my son and I will be, but mainly like tomato, cucumber, peppers,
onions,
radishes, and lettuces.
Beans.
Help me, John.
Potatoes, beans, corn, squash.
Beets.
Strawberries, we actually do. I said we didn't plant yet. We actually do have our alpine strawberries in already up there. And they're doing really well. So a few years we'll be harvesting them.
A lot of native stuff.
As a matter of fact, thank you for that up. I want you guys to.
And herbs and sprouts.
And
also.
Herbs and sprouts. Stick your hand out and wash it. There could be some in there. All right, take one, pass it on.
I hope we have enough.
If you don't think you will plant any seed, don't take one. But I'm trying to encourage you to plant seed and seed solved. All right? The first time, if you really want to see a miracle, plant a seed and watch it grow. When my son and daughter started seeing that, I saw it as a young child. My daddy taught me how to garden really young. And it was just a miracle to me. I mean, when I was, yes.
I
Do you plan on just staying in like the vegetable market, or could you break into like the meat market also?
In what market?
Like the meat market.
My son wants to get into the meat market because he has a catering business. Yeah. He's buying for flying in now and another ranch up in Colorado, close by, up in southern Colorado here, so he's wanting to buy all the organic meats. And it's very expensive, and he wants to grow our own pigs and our own cows. Well, I don't want to grow pigs and cows on my produce farm, so we'll have to buy another piece of property, which we're looking at up in Hampton Park right now, and he'll grow pigs and cows on that. The cows take an enormous amount of land.
What about sheep for grazing?
I have one of our good friends, my wife's in a rock band up there, and her singer is wife is a sheep farmer, an organic sheep farmer, and she raises the Navajo breed. So anytime I need sheep, I go to her. When she wants something from me, we trade. So that's how we do that. That's a great question, too, yeah.